Hi, I'm Chris Palmore, and this is the Tim Ferriss Show Extended Recap, Episode 2, Josh Waitzkin. Thanks for joining me for this special edition. If you're enjoying these reviews, please leave a comment below. So, jumping right in. The brain is an amazing organ, and listening to a man that can play 30 to 50 games of chess simultaneously was enough for me to want to tune in. I had listened to this episode back in May, and it inspired me to get the audiobook for The Art of Learning. Now, listening to this episode again this week with paper and pen in hand, it really made me enjoy it on a whole new level. Firstly, Tim, when do we get into part two you mentioned in this interview? And when we do, I think you should name it something like Joshua Waitzkin, the man with the Zen or the Weight Zen. Okay, during the interview, Josh mentions unlearning, and it made me think of this really great quote by Danielle Laporte. Can you remember who you were before the world told you who you should be? Now, there are many great statements in this interview. Here's just a few. Cultivate quality. If you're not cultivating quality, you are cultivating sloppiness. Build a life around being true. Live a life trapped in love. Now, there's a wonderful section in the middle where they discuss meditation. And I remember this from the first listen. I had started meditating recently, and it stuck out to me when they mentioned that most of the top performers in the finance world meditated. It takes a clear mind to do amazing work. So be open-minded and listen to this section as a student eager to learn. I promise you that you will pick up something of value. The more people that share life-changing ideas, the more likely someone's life will be changed. I'm a big fan of the meditation app Headspace, and we'll have a link to their site below. So check it out and do a take 10. It's 10 minutes of meditation for 10 days. Now, meditation, it doesn't take away the fear of pain. What it allows you to do is to be able to sit with it. It trains you to be able to act in those situations instead of reacting. Act, don't react, is a motto I cling to in my life. Tim Gray gave a really great quote to illustrate this by Custer D'Auto. The hero and the coward. I tell you, my kids, what is the difference between the hero and the coward? What is the difference between being yellow and being brave? No difference. It's only what you do. They both feel the same. They both fear dying and getting hurt. The man who is yellow refuses to face up to what he has to face up to, and the hero is more disciplined, and he fights those feelings off, and he does what has to be done. But they both feel the same. The hero and the coward, people watch you, judge you on what you do, not how you feel. So check out meditation. There are many paths to choose from. Next, Tim asked Josh what one item he would take with him if his house were on fire and his family were already safe. I'll give you a hint. It's not a laptop. You only make that mistake once, right, Josh? So Josh closes this episode with a really great line. So I'm going to steal it, just like any great artist would do, and say, don't forget the love. I'm Chris Palmore, and that was the Tim Ferriss Show Extended Recap. I'll see you next week.